Welcome to this session on architecture design. In this session, we'll discuss the topics that should be captured and documented as part of the architecture design document. These include the goals of the architecture design, the solution overview, and the four-layer canvas design. We'll also discuss the importance of validating the architecture design. So let's go ahead and get started. The goals of the architecture design are to show how the solution will be built and fully understand the technical ecosystem. This will allow us to remove any uncertainties and possible roadblocks, as well as explore new and innovative solutions. In the end, the architecture design will also help with development planning. So we will start by building a high-level solution overview. The high-level overview should be understandable by the business users. It's representing business concepts and how they'll map to the overall solution. In the following example, the solution overview depicts the concepts that are from different types of entities, and this allows us to verify if our understanding of the concepts are correct before we begin designing more of the system. In this solution overview, we can also see things depicted with the applications, roles, and even parts of the user stories. Here we can see the application is built of several modules. We can see how these modules relate, how each role will access each module, and how they accomplish their part of the process. Once we've created the solution overview, we can move to the next level of detail, which can be captured on the four-layer canvas. The four-layer canvas is a framework that supports architecture design. It allows us to provide a more detailed architecture design. Using the four-layer canvas can speed up architecture design because it gives us a systematic approach of doing it. It promotes common understanding between the business and users and enables easy validation of architectures because there are supporting tools that can help us do the validation. To design an architecture with a canvas, we need to identify all the business requirements, then all the non-functional requirements, and group those requirements into different concepts and represent them on the four-layer canvas. If you'd like to learn more about the four-layer canvas, you can check out the link provided here. So if this sounds very helpful, let's look at a practical example. This example was actually built as part of a business vision. In black are modules that represent external systems. These will integrate with our solution through the integration services in the library layer, where there are also non-functional requirements. In orange is the core business layer, where all our core business processes and concepts should go. And also, we can see the APIs that are available for external systems to use. At the top right, we can actually see two external systems that are going to consume these APIs. The blue layer represents end user modules or user interfaces, and the dark blue, portals or orchestration types of modules. Like the other documents before, the architecture design document needs to be validated. Not properly validating this represents a risk for future development. Without validation, we could have incorrectly estimated some of the technical aspects or are even proposing a solution that may be impossible to implement. So to sum things up, the architecture design doesn't need to be too detailed, but it needs to cover all technical aspects. In the end, it should be detailed enough that we can build a project plan around it. So that's it for the architecture design document. Thanks for watching. And have a great day.